Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. I do believe, that is host ending the game again.
As it explodes.
Yeah, we are in for an exciting time today.
Yeah, it's gonna be a fun one. Unfortunately, the feature station, like Scott and I would love, they have refs and stuff, and people running back and forth. Scott and I would love to just scream at the players. Unfortunately, the feature station is basically completely across for all the open section we have here. It's at the far corner, so I can't even just go harass them and be like, let's go, guys.
Yeah, so we get to sit here and play the game of which game is actually going to be the correct one.
We can talk, since we haven't had anything happen in the open bracket, we can talk a little bit about what we've seen so far.
Yeah.
A couple of surprises, really. I mean, we thought the games were going to be very, very, very close between Epsilon and TK, and the games were ridiculously close.
Amazing.
TCM, we actually picked to win that one, and FaZe Red kind of surprised me a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, it was an absolutely amazing series, and I think, TK looked good. I mean, I think they deserved the win. I mean, we saw them clutch up so much at X Games, and I think we were both kind of wondering, will that be able to carry over here and beating Epsilon 3-0, even though the series was so close.
It's the closest 3-0, of all time.
Of all time, but it doesn't matter, because still a
3-0.
But I still think, TK's looking very, very good going into this one, and this is going to be our fourth attempt to join Domination on Strike Zone here.
I think this is lucky number four.
Is that a thing?
Or the third. I'm not really sure which one we're on.
No, it's definitely the fourth. But, so, Strike Zone Domination, you guys are going to see a lot of subplay. We've only seen one professional player ever pull out an AR on it in the recent months, and that was Goonjar, and that was actually at X Games.
He didn't pull out very long, if I
remember. No. It was like 5 seconds, but
I'm really going to be watching, the big thing for me is going to be seeing the splits with the MTAR and Vector, because one of the big things you saw, I mean, Optic was one of the only teams that really stayed very MTAR heavy at X Games. Everyone else was running three, some teams they actually ran four Vectors, some of them, whereas Optic stuck with the three MTAR approach. So we'll see how that works out. And the other thing to keep an eye on as well is this whole silenced MTAR thing, which it sort of looked that way. If you don't know what I'm talking about, there's been some rumors flying around that possibly the bullet registration is a little bit quicker when you have a silencer on the MTAR. And I don't know who we were watching use it earlier, but it sure looked that way.
Wow. God, who was that? Man, I forget too. But, yeah, I mean, it looks like the silencer does actually register just a little bit faster, first bullet, which makes the MTAR even more lethal here. But so in case you're not familiar here with Strike Zone Domination or Domination in general, you want to make sure you cap the flag. You're going to get a tick every 5 seconds on the point score. And traditionally, it's all about the two cap. And on this map, very rarely do we ever see a three cap happen.
Yeah, and this is interesting. I mean, typically, you'll usually see kind of a two-on-two engagement sort of at B, but B was given up actually pretty – I mean, they took that easily. There was really no contest. One player puts their kitchen, caught a knife, and they've got easy two-cap control. They should be able to set up on C as well here. So good start so far, and we'll see if they can counter back.
Yep, we're going to go ahead and jump on board with Invert. Invert now, he's got a teammate there. They see that they're going to be dual hopping here on C, and they have a perfect control. And there's going to be four members who are coming off the respawn here for this opposition. And Invert's going to be cleaned up there. And Can Alien, that's a cool name, isn't it?
It's like Canadian, but alien. Will end up dropping. We got Kevin Durant here as well, as he's gonna fall. Yeah, I have no idea if the players right now are actually playing under their actual tags or just making up some funny names. I like never dropped 30.
There is a stain bow in the game, so let's jump on board with never drop 30.
Yeah.
He's 2-4 right now. Looks like he's going to be pushing into Closet, and I actually do like this play because they're going to need some kind of a two-cap control here. They're losing A, and you would rather see him kind of push into the Closet and start getting control on this B, but now he's going to go by himself. Gets cleaned up from the side.
Yeah, a little bit of timing there. Easy kill for Durant as he was checking the left here. We're on with Stainville of Strictly Business. not actually him. I'm going to go ahead and guess, but he will set up here in bar. He's going to get pressure from a couple guys. It looks like they were spawning A. He's got one coming in from Closet. This should be an easy kill, but I don't think he actually even pulled the trigger there. A little bit of a quicker reaction out of Durant.
Yeah, realize now does have one. Oh, he's just going to get shut down there. And Can Alien has another guy, and he is kind of going on a little bit of a tear here. He's on a 5-spree. He's 8-3. So he's kind of just been having his way with them, and he's really just waiting for his teammates to kind of come in and help him on the rotation.
Yeah, and they've jumped out to an early lead. We're up 17 right now. They are losing A. There's going to be a big engagement. He will win that one. That was Paradise with the defense. So they will maintain control of B and C here. The score is going to continue to increase. On board with Invert here. It looks like he's going to rotate here, kind of cover this spawn push to B. As you can see, they're all going to be spawning. I see they're actually getting a little bit of pressure on A right now.
Yeah, Invert now. There is going to be a guy coming up the courtyard. And as we take a look at the minimap, I mean, you know, the rotation of Invert and the team has been really, really good. Oh, God, he turned on that guy. And the last guy is going to be in the kitchen here, and he should have an easy kill, acquire his weapon, and then basically kill out everyone. And, you know, I do actually prefer the MTAR on this map, Miv. I really do. I think the Vector slows it down way too much because of all the pre-aiming.
Yeah, no, it can certainly slow down your play, and that's what we saw at X Games. Some teams, especially teams like EG, were playing a little bit differently than they typically do, a little bit slower, more pre-aiming instead of, you know, just constant aggression with the MTAR, so we'll have to see how that will play out. It looks like Realize, I don't believe that's the actual Realize, but I think he's struggling a little bit right now, 1-13. They have another teammate, 3-10 right now, so they're really going to have to get it going, as the lead's already jumped out to what? They're up 32. This is starting to look a little bit like a blowout.
Yep, Durant now pulls his aim away from him, comes back on him, still kills him, 76-43. This one's getting a little bit ugly, and now you kind of expect Realize to kind of need to turn up a little bit for his team here in the last 70 seconds if they want to chip away at this lead. But this kind of a point lead going into side number two is a little bit insane.
Yeah, I mean, if this was, let's say, Octane or, you know, maps where you can see a two cap that's, you know, we've had 40 and 50 point swings we've seen in the Season 2 League before, yep. But you don't really see those very often on this map. I think it was, what, X Games where... What was it, a 30-point advantage for OpTic over EG, and they almost pulled that one back. But that's, I mean, they completely outplayed them in the second half, but it's just such a substantial lead in this particular map. It's so, so hard to come back from.
Yeah, I mean, the big thing, too, is, you know, it's a little bit more close quarters. You're going to be rotating from side to side. As long as you can go 2-2 in gunfights, I mean, you should be able to at least have one flag, which you're never going to get a 3-cap. It's very, very difficult, but... Final 20 seconds here, in case you're brand new to Domination. We play one side 5 minutes, then we flip sides 5 minutes. It's all about fairness.
Yeah, and the final will take, at least, you know, what's nice here is the update. You know, we don't have to go out, try and host another game. We're just going to flip right to the second side, which, about a month ago, I guess they put that in there, which makes it a lot easier for us casters, too. We don't have to really work too much math, which if you've ever watched Golden Boy cast, it is hysterical.
Yeah,
he's typically got a calculator out on his phone, like adding 10 plus 12.
Yeah, my favorite thing he ever did was it was like a 79 to like 68 point, and he was like, oh, 9-point game. I was like, yeah, 9 points, Alex.
Exactly. But we are going to go into side two, and looks like it is, what, 48-point advantage right now. So this one's going to be so, so, so tough to come back from. Paradise able to get some hit markers across there, trying to finish up the kill. No luck. I mean, it looks like we had a team kill there. Never dropped 30, unfortunately, taking out one of his teammates.
Yep, Paradise, 18-11. Can Alien has one, cleans him up. They should be hopping on B right now, but as you take a look at the minimap, we're seeing a little bit of action here over on A, and this is good because they will be setting up for a little bit of a spawn trap, but no one is at C, so this is going to give Can Alien a very, very good chance here to kind of hop on C flag.
Well, you can see they had a couple guys spawning A. I think two, you look at the minimap here, two, make that three, are starting to flood up towards B and mid control. So this battle in bar to hold down B will be a big one. It looks like Canalian did come out on top, able to take out Never Drop 30 and maintain B control. But there is another player. Thought he was going to be actually pushing through kitchen. Looks like he's going to rotate over to C.
Yeah, and I really like this play, actually, sitting here in the back of Stature. I mean, you can kind of bait C just a little bit, give your teammates time in case they push through Pro Shop, which, you know, they've been pushing consistently through Pro Shop every single time. That's a nice two-piece there by Kevin Durant. That's all four dead. And now that's going to reward them with C flag. 3 minutes and 40 seconds left on the clock. This one's getting ugly.
Yeah, this is going to be a tough one to come back from, but we'll see if they can work any magic. This is getting to the point where you're going to need basically a 3-cap almost for the remainder here. But just taking a look at the KDs, you can see why the score is where it stands. Everyone pretty significantly positive here. Wakanele 18-9, Invert 18-7 with 3 and 4 caps respectively. So they're really, really dominating right now.
A little bit of T-Rex arms there. Can Alien sitting in the back of the bar. He's just going to lock this down for his team. We're going to jump on board with Invert. Has one guy in his sight. Can he clean him up? Nope. He gets out of dodge. And now Durant and Paradise are all coming on the help side.
And able to pick one up on C, but he did have a little bit of help with his teammates, so they will maintain control of that. They're actually pushing a three cap right now. It looks like they are getting to the pro shop. Well, Courtyard Spawn going to be flooding up the main stairs here. Inward look to his right, just as two were about to push up the stairs, and that's another example of contact.
Oh, God, that was filthy three-piece there by Durant as he just crapped on his opposition. So now the members will all be spawning at C flag. This is going to be Durant locking this one up, all four going through pro shop. Very unique strategy. We see it sometimes, but really, when you push through pro shop, it's like a 15-second push, whereas you can push right into closet in about 7. Normally what we see from top-tier players.
Yeah, and, you know, in the early rounds, we're going to see some games like this that are a little lopsided here.
Oh, yeah.
Not too much of a contest here for Durant and crew, but able to pick up another kill there. Pretty much the entire squad right now is almost double positive. Up, 70 points approximately here with 2 minutes left to go in this game one. And, again, if you are just tuning in, it's going to be best of threes throughout here. So, really, I mean, in a lot of these, we may just be seeing two games. We'll be cruising through. I mean, we have all best of fives on Alpha, so I got to think we're going to cruise through some of these games, at least compared to the main stage.
Yep, and they've been locked down here on C, but at least they were able to get the spot out. It is mathematically impossible for them to win, and now we are seeing as Invert and the rest of the troops drop the trophy system down, win some gunfights, and really just keep asserting their dominance. They want to keep the momentum as much as humanly possible going into game number two, Search and Destroy.
Yeah, we'll check and see at least for the squad. Are they running? How many vectors are they running?
Which one?
The guys with Durant, Ember, yeah, you go through it.
All four MTARs.
All four MTARs, okay. I know we saw a couple.
Oh, no,
couple
one vector.
One vector, okay. Sorry. Yeah, that's one thing I want to keep an eye on this weekend.
Yeah.
To see what people, you know, it's kind of like think back to, what was it, regionals, where one of the big things that really helped propel SB was, you know, steady in. People weren't really all using it, caught people by surprise, and I sort of felt like X Games was sort of, everyone seemed to want to switch to the vector, and styles kind of changed, and it was kind of a wake-up call to, like, I know Envy was definitely, you know, they didn't finish the way they expected.
That's true.
EG was kind of surprised, too. So I know a lot of teams have been trying to figure out that mix of which subs they like to run. So we'll see as the weekend goes on what people tend to favor.
Well, Durant's actually genuinely impressed me throughout this game. I mean, he's been having his way with his opposition.
And that's his teammate there. I think it's Headshot Paradise. Got a little trigger happy, but 20 seconds left here. We may have the 200-point club in just a moment here. But, looking across, Katie's with 30 and 12, 5 caps, 31 and 15 for Durant. So really good start for these guys. And this will be tough, I think. The S&D, I know S&D is quite different from any of the respawns, but it just seems to have a little bit of a mismatch here in the early rounds.
Yeah. So taking a look at the round ending kill cam here, Invert 31 and 13, 5 captures. He's really putting on for his city, Mav.
Yeah. Oklahoma City Thunder.
Oklahoma City Thunder. Woohoo! The Durantula. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to hop to a quick commercial break. When we come back, game number two, Search and Destroy. Stay tuned.